Hello people, it's Crimson, and today I'm going to be showing you how to use an external hard drive on your Xbox. Now I just plugged it in, and there should be a notification that'll show up. Here we go. External media storage ready. I believe if I open that notification, it'll just take me to media player, which I don't want to do. So I'm going to go to settings, system, I'm already at system. Then storage. If I go over here, there is manage storage, which has the internal, which is the normal Xbox storage, and Seagate portable drive, which is my external hard drive. So right now it's used for pictures, music, and videos. So I'm gonna format it to games and apps, so this way it could have actual games on it. I've seen other YouTube tutorials that say that this message right here shows up immediately when they plug it in, but mine didn't, so I just went into settings to get it myself. So I'm going to use this for games, so I'm gonna have to format it. So formatting it will delete everything that you have on the hard drive, and I just got mine, so there's obviously nothing on it, but if you have important files on that, they're all gonna get deleted. So I would not use that hard drive, I would get another one or take the files off of it. So I'm gonna format it. I'll just call it Xbox External. Okay, so this is to either install new games or apps that you get from this point on. If you want it to default to the hard drive or if you want it to go onto the normal internal Xbox storage. Now I'm gonna choose install new things here because, well, I can't 100% confirm this reason. It might depend on how good your hard drive is, but I think games will actually load faster if I have it on the external hard drive. But I can't confirm that. But even if it doesn't, I still want it on the external hard drive because you can actually take out the external hard drive and bring it to another Xbox. Like, you can bring it to your friend's house, and you plug the external hard drive into their Xbox, and the games will automatically be downloaded to it. You don't have to download it from the Xbox Live Store or anything, because that can take hours. You will need the disc, though, if you have a disc. But you can just plug it right in. If it's digital games, it'll work immediately. So that'll be really useful. So I'm going to do that. And you can change it anytime as well. So I'm going to confirm this. And cool, so now it's games and apps, except there's one thing. All of my games right now are still on my internal, not my external, because you can see 64% used on internal, 0 on my new external hard drive. So I'm actually gonna put all of my games onto the external instead. And it's not like when you first download the game after buying it, where it can take a long time to download, because there's a direct connection, so it can actually only take a minute. So that's really, really good. I really don't want to have to download every single game. So you can just press the menu button, then go to manage game and add-ons, and then you'll be on this screen, or you could also just press the view button, and it should take you there as well. But all you need to do is go here to move all under internal, and then you can, it'll automatically go to Xbox external, since that's the only other one that I have. So I'll just press move, and this is a 75.2 gigabyte game, so let's see how long this takes. Okay, so this game is 75 gigabytes, which is a lot more than the average game, but I figured out that it takes 10 seconds for 1 gigabyte, which means a 6 gigabyte game should only take a minute. That also means a 30 gigabyte game should take about 5 minutes. And this probably will vary if you're on an Xbox One S or X, because I'm on the original Xbox One, and this shouldn't have anything to do with your internet speed. So that will probably change it, and it'll be faster if you're on an Xbox One S or X. Thank you guys so much for watching this tutorial. I hope it worked. If it did, leave a like and subscribe. If it didn't, leave a comment. I'll try my best to help you. Even if this video is 2 years old, I'll still probably reply. And if there's a video link in the description that says there's an updated tutorial, watch that first because that should be updated and have the problem fixed. So that way you won't need to leave a comment at all. But anyway, that's it. Goodbye.